Hello friends, we are going to discuss about the applications of semiconductor too. Myself, B.N. Zamada, I am from Walchand College of Engineering, Sangli. Today we are going to discuss about the transistor and transistor section. We know that transistor is the transfer plus trans plus ester, and trans means transfer the signal from the low resistance to the high resistance. So transistor having three different layers, three different terminals and two junction semiconductor device. So there are two different types of transistors, one PNP transistor and second one NPN transistor. So for PNP transistor, N type of semiconductor is sandwiched between two P type semiconductor, and in case of NPN transistor, P type semiconductor is sandwiched between two N type semiconductor. So in case of PNP transistor, this P layer and this is the P layer, what is the difference? The size of this layer is maximum as compared to this layer. So that's why the terminal from this layer is always emitter, and the terminal from this layer is always collector, and the terminal from middle is base. So this is emitter, base and collector. But what is the difference between this P layer and this P layer? This is the highly doped trivalent impurity, and this is moderately doped trivalent impurity, and this is lightly doped pentavalent impurity. That's why this is emitter, base and collector. Similarly for NPN transistor, and this is the symbol of PNP and NPN. So what is the difference? For PNP transistor, the arrow is given to the emitter terminal, which is inward, and arrow is given to the emitter, but which is in the upward direction. So this arrow indicates that this is NPN transistor and this is PNP transistor. Now, the transistor section. In PNP transistor, emitter base junction should be in the forward bias condition and collector base junction in the reverse bias condition. So for forward bias condition of a emitter base junction, the positive terminal of battery is connected to P, negative terminal is connected to N, due to which it is in the forward bias condition. And in case of a collector base junction, positive terminal is given to N, negative terminal is given to P. This is in the reverse bias condition. So what will happen? So due to the forward bias condition, some electrons, some majority holes are in the emitter layer. These holes, they are shifted into the n-type semiconductor, but this is the minority charge carriers here, or this is called the weakly, weakly doped. So a few electrons are there. So few electrons, they are interact with the number of holes are available, and due to which a very small amount of current passes through. This current is called as the base current, and remaining holes are shifted towards the collector region of this collector terminal. So that's why the current passing through this transistor. So very small amount of base current, there will be the large amount of collector current. Similarly, this is the NPN type transistor. So this is the forward bias condition of base emitter base junction and collector base junction in the reverse bias condition. So when number of electrons they are cross this junction, out of them two or maybe a few holes are there. So these electrons, they are interact with the holes, and remaining electron will cross the junction and they will attract it towards the positive terminal battery, and that's why there is a large current passing through the collector. So base current is very small, collector current is large, and that's why the total emitter current is the addition of these two current, that is IE is equal to IB plus IC. Now we are going to discuss about the relation in between alpha and beta. What is alpha and what is beta? So there are three different modes of a configuration. This is CB configuration, because we know that transistor having three terminals, and when they are connected in two port network, one of the terminals should be connected to ground for the common, and that's why when the base in the common mode, that is it is connected to ground, this is called as a common base. When the emitter is in the common mode, that is it is connected to ground, this is called as a common emitter mode. And when collector is in the it is connected to ground, it is called as a common collector mode. So in case of a CB mode, that is common base mode, this is the emitter current, input current, this is collector current, output current. So output current divided by input current is called as the current amplification factor, and this amplification factor is denoted by alpha. So this is the current amplification factor, alpha is equal to IC upon IE. In case of common emitter mode, output current is collector current, input current is the base current, and ratio of output to the input is the beta, that is beta is equal to IC upon IB. But we know that IC, alpha is equal to IC upon IE, that is IC upon IE means IB plus IC. Therefore, 1 upon alpha is equal to IB plus IC upon IC. And when this particular splitting into two different terms, IB upon IC plus 1, and this one is shifted towards the left, 1 upon alpha minus 1 is equal to beta. So, beta is equal to alpha upon 1 minus alpha. Now, we are going to discuss about the transistor's characteristic. There are three different types of characteristic, like input characteristic, output characteristic, and transfer characteristic. In input characteristic, input voltage is a changes. Input voltage is a changes with respect to the input current for constant VCE, that is output collector to emitter voltage for the common base configuration. So as we increase the base emitter voltage, initially current becomes zero, and further that it increases, not in the linear form, but this is in the exponential form. It is initially this change is very small, but further that this change will be larger. So this curve is the exponential curve. And take the ratio of change in VB to the change in IB, will get the input impedance RI. That is, the ratio of I delta IB upon delta VB is the slope, but 1 upon slope is the input resistance of the transistor. Then we are going to discuss about the output characteristic. And in this output characteristic, the output voltage VC versus this output current IC, that is collector current IC, for constant IB. So when we take the base current 0, as we increase the collector to emitter voltage, initially current increases with very small value, but further that collector current remains constant. So for different values of IB, we will get this nature. For IB is equal to 20 microampere, initially this value of the collector current is maximum, further that remains constant. For this is for 40 microampere, this is for 60 microampere, this is for 80 microampere, this is for 100 microampere. So take different means it perform the different experiment for different values of IB. And now from this graph it is clear that this region is called the saturation region, this region is called the cutoff region, and this region is called the active region. So when the transistor is used as an amplifier, we should use in the operating point in the active region. If the operating point is shifted into saturation region, it becomes on switch, and when the operating point is shifted in the cutoff region, it is in the off switch. So if you want to use the transistor in the used as a transistor as a amplifier, we should use the operating point in the active region. Now, transfer characteristic. In transfer characteristic check, the change in a collector current to change in a base current. If there is a change in a collector current to for the change in base current, this ratio is the transfer characteristic, and this curve is about linear curve. This is linear curve. So as we increase the base current, it linearly increases the collector current. And we know that transistor is used as an amplifier. We should use the common emitter configuration. Input voltage is given to base emitter, and output voltage is appeared across the collector. Load resistance RC, because the load resistance is connected to collector with respect to the supply. So for variation of this input, we get the variation at the output, but output whose amplitude is greater than that of the input, this is called an amplifier. So similarly, transistor acts as a switch. For switch function, we should use either in the saturation region or in the cutoff region. When the base voltage is low, the collector voltage is high. That is, it gives the output voltage 1. But if the input voltage is high, large amount of current pass through, it does not pass through the load resistance RL. So RL means it is connected to C with respect to ground. But if we want to see the voltage across RC, for low voltage, large amount of current, for low voltage, no current pass through it, so voltage across them is zero. And for high voltage, the transistor is in the saturation region, high current pass through it, and due to which the voltage across RC is maximum. It acts as a switch. Similarly, a transistor is used in the different applications like oscillator. And this oscillator is to convert DC into AC. This transistor is a feedback amplifier, but feedback amplifier is oscillator only when the two conditions are must be satisfied. One is A into beta is equals to 1, and second, when the total phase shift of the entire loop must be equals to 0 or multiple of 2 pi. Thank you. Thank you very much.